everyone. Welcome to Live Interactive English. This is Karen.
Hello, everybody. I am Shane.
Today, we're looking at part one of Is Handwriting History? And the vocabulary words are barely.
Barely.
Derek barely got to work on time today.
Similarly.
Similarly.
Similarly, other painters began using common objects in their art.
Requirement.
Requirement.
A requirement to vote is that you must be over 18 years old.
Standard.
Standard.
The house was built according to city standards.
Rid.
Rid.
Kara told me a way to get rid of mice without killing them.
I like mice.
Oh, really?
Hello.
Okay, so we're not talking about mice today. We're talking about handwriting.
Handwriting.
When was the last time that you've, you know, written a letter by hand?
Does it count if it's like a Christmas card or a Valentine's Day card? I do tend to write a lot in there.
Okay, well, if you write a lot, then I think it counts.
I think that's the only time is when I'm writing my wife a Christmas card
or a
birthday card or Valentine's Day card. Then I use handwriting, and she always thinks, oh my God, it's so beautiful, but she can't really understand.
She can't really understand cursive writing.
Cursive handwriting.
Yeah, but I think cursive writing is so beautiful.
Mm.
And then people nowadays, they don't really use it anymore. Many people just type.
Type or type.
Or text.
Or type.
Right?
Yeah, so I think a lot of school systems are starting to teach typing rather than writing or doing cursive writing.
I know.
It's starting to get replaced because it's not as useful anymore.
And I think even some schools, they have gotten rid of their written exams because the students' writing is just too messy. It's really hard to read.
Yeah.
So you can kind of just use your laptop. You can type your exams.
That makes sense.
Maybe that's like the future. But I really don't know. But
good or bad?
I like writing.
Let's discuss good or bad next time.
All right.
Okay.
Enjoy writing.
Okay.
Is handwriting history? When was the last time you wrote out a letter by hand? If you're like most people, then your answer is a long time ago. Today, most people prefer to type things on an electronic device. In fact, there is barely any need to write anything by hand aside from school homework.And even that is changing.
Welcome to Live Interactive English Magazine. Today's lesson is called, Is Handwriting History? Part 1. Hi everyone, my name is Jeff.
And I'm Mike. This is a very interesting question that we're facing in the world that we live in today. It's a modern world, a world of electronic devices, people typing out messages or drawing things with their finger or using software programs on computers. So what about holding a pen and writing something by hand? It's something that a lot of people don't do today. So when we ask the question, is handwriting history?We're saying, has the time of handwriting passed us by? Are we in a post-handwriting world?
That's a good point. Is handwriting history? Will people use their hand to write things in the future? Or is handwriting history? Is it going to go away? And when our article begins, it asks a pretty good question, all right? And this makes me think that maybe handwriting is going away. When was the last time you wrote out a letter by hand? It's got to be years, many, many years since I've done this. So maybe, just maybe, handwriting is going away.
That's right. If you're like most people, as Jeff said he is, if you're like most people, then your answer is a long time ago. That was the last time you wrote a letter by hand, or most people wrote a letter by hand. Not recently, a long time ago, maybe even years ago. Why? Well, here's the answer. Today, most people prefer to type things on an electronic device. You're either typing with your hands on a keyboard or maybe using your thumb on a smartphone, but you're not using a pen and paper.
Now, you're mentioning electronic devices there, iPads, tablets, laptop computers. These are all electronic devices. Anyways, let's move on here. The next sentence says, in fact, there is barely any need to write anything by hand aside from school homework, and even that is changing. So we used to think, sure, these kids are texting with one another, but they'll always have to do their homework by hand. So for that reason, handwriting is not going to go away anytime soon, but even that is changing.
That's right. More and more kids aren't even writing at school. They're taking computers and just typing out their work at school. So as the first sentence there said, there is barely any need to write anything by hand, both in school and in your private life, and even if you work in an office. There's barely any need to write by hand. Barely, this adverb means to a very, very small degree, to a very small amount, almost zero, almost none, but there's a little bit there. If it's 2 degrees outside, you might say, oh, it's so cold, it's barely above freezing. It's just a little bit above zero, the freezing mark. Or if you have some cold food and you put it in the microwave for 10 seconds, By the time you take it out, it would be barely warm. It hasn't had enough time to warm up, so it's barely warm enough to eat. It might have a little heat there, but almost zero. So we use barely to talk about something that is just above none. For example, Derek barely got to work on time today. He was 1 minute early.
He almost didn't get to work on time. It was close. All right, folks, with that, it's time for us to take a break, but don't go away. We'll be right back after this.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。同学们上一次用手写信是什么时候呢？你还会亲自写生日卡片祝福朋友吗？还是你都用手机、电脑传几句祝福，或是传贴图给人家呢？现在大多数的人都很仰赖电子设备，也都在电子设备上面打字。除了学校作业之外，几乎很少需要用手写任何东西。那我们这两天的课文就是要探讨书写是不是要走入历史了。课文标题里面的 handwriting 表示笔迹或是字迹啊，书写它是当名词。那么单字 barely 它是副词，表示几乎没有或是勉强的，仅仅。另外文中的 electronic device 表示电子装置，其中这个 electronic 它是形容电子的，那么 device 表示装置或是设备。接回课文中。
Is handwriting history? In recent years, some countries have begun cutting handwriting lessons from schools. For example, schools in Finland have replaced handwriting lessons with typing courses. Educators there believe that typing is more useful for modern life. Similarly, the requirement to learn cursive has been removed from national education standards in the United States.
Get this, everyone. In recent years, some countries have begun cutting handwriting lessons from schools. So there you have it. Maybe handwriting is history. After all, if you don't learn handwriting at school, how are you going to learn it at all? Anyways, some countries are cutting handwriting lessons from schools. Countries like Finland.
That's right. In the European country of Finland, it says, for example, schools in Finland have replaced handwriting lessons with typing courses. So 5 or 10 years ago, kids might have spent an hour or two a week practicing handwriting, learning how to write well and write their letters properly. But now they've taken out those classes and replaced them with typing courses or typing classes. The idea here is that, well, kids don't write with a pen, but they will use a computer a lot, It's more useful if they can type quickly and accurately. As it says, educators there believe that typing is more useful for modern life. And educators is just another word for teachers and people like that.
Which makes sense. Yeah. If you're going to grow up and use a computer for the rest of your life, maybe typing is more useful than writing with your hand on a piece of paper. Anyways, that's enough for Finland. Let's talk about the United States next. Similarly, the requirement to learn cursive has been removed from national education standards in the United States. Now, what they're saying here is that in the United States, they haven't stopped teaching handwriting like they have in Finland, but they've done something similar, okay? They've removed the cursive requirement from national education standards. Now, cursive, that's called script writing. That's the fancy writing where all the letters, they connect so you can write more quickly and still clearly. That's cursive writing. But soon, you won't have to learn cursive at all in the United States. That has been removed from national education standards. Now, we've got three vocabulary words to talk about here. The first of these is the adverb similarly. The adverb is similarly. The adjective is similar. Okay, if two things are similar, they're a lot alike. They're not the same, but they're pretty close. For example, similarly, other painters began using common objects in their art.
Ah, interesting. So in this way, America and Finland are kind of alike. They're not focusing on handwriting, but focusing more on computers. So the cursive requirement is no longer there in America. A requirement, this is basically something that is necessary, something that must be done or needs to be done. If you're driving a car, there is a requirement that you have a driver's license and have passed a test. That is something you must have to drive a car legally. On an airplane, when it's taking off, they will check that you have your seat belt fastened, and if you don't, they will tell you to put it on. It is a requirement to fasten your seat belt before the plane takes off. Something that must be done, that has to be done. For example, a requirement to vote is that you must be over 18 years old. It's also a requirement that you are a citizen of that country.
Right? You have to meet these requirements.
That's right.
Otherwise, you can't vote. Now, before we take a break, we also have the word standard to talk about. It's a noun. Here, a standard is a widely agreed upon way of doing something. Everybody agrees to do something in a certain way and at a certain level as far as quality is concerned. For example, the house was built according to city standards. Okay, the city says these are the rules, this is how you have to build things, these are our standards. All right, folks, with that, it's time for us to take a break, but don't go away. We'll be right back after this.
刚刚说到，除了学校作业，几乎很少会需要用手写任何东西。不过这个情况也在改变哦。近年来，有一些国家开始删减学校的书写课程，像芬兰的学校已经改用打字课来取代手写课。芬兰的教育工作者认为，在现代生活中，打字是比较有用的。同样的，在美国，他们已经不需要学草写了。学习草写这个要求已经从国家教育标准中移除掉了。我们先来看三个单字。Similar， 它是形容相似的、类似的。那我们课文里面的 similarly 是它的副词，表示同样的或是相似的。那么 require 这个动词，它表示需要、要求。那我们课文的单字 requirement 它是它的名词，来表达要求或是必要条件、需要的东西。至于 standard 它表示标准、规范，是当名词用。好，那我们来看几个补充单字。 Finland 表示芬兰。 Educator 表示教育工作者或是教育学家。那么 cursive 它表示草写体或是草书。好，那草书其实也可以称为 script script, script. 我们可以用 write in script 或者是 write in cursive 来表达用草写的方式写字。接回课文中。
Is handwriting history? Some schools have even gotten rid of written exams and now allow students to complete exams using laptops instead. This is because students' handwriting has become so poor that it's difficult to read, making it hard to mark exams. Besides, students tend to use laptops to take notes instead of writing things by hand, thus losing their handwriting ability.
No handwriting, no cursive, and there's more. Some schools have even gotten rid of written exams and now allow students to complete exams using laptops instead.
Wow, so they don't even need to write in an exam or in a test. They can bring in a computer and type their answers instead of writing them. It's to get rid of something, rid this verb. It's an irregular verb, rid, rid, rid. So it's very easy to remember. It doesn't change for the past tense. And it basically means to do away with something, to throw away something, to take active steps to remove it from yourself or from where you are. You get rid of your garbage by putting it in a garbage bag and taking it out to the garbage truck. That's the way you want to lose it. If you put on a few extra pounds, you might say, I'm going to go to the gym and get rid of this extra weight. For example, Kara told me a way to get rid of mice without killing them. Oh. So I have mice in the kitchen. I don't want them there, but I don't want to hurt them. So there is a safe way to get rid of those mice.
You can eliminate the mice without killing them. Anyways,Let's talk about how written exams might also be history. Well, this is because students' handwriting has become so poor that it's difficult to read, making it hard to mark or to grade exams.
Wow.
So there you go. The written exam might go the way of cursive and handwriting as well. And besides...Students tend to use laptops to take notes instead of writing things by hand, thus losing their handwriting ability. So people are using laptops all the time. They can't write so well anymore. Their handwriting is illegible. So, hey, why not get rid of written exams, too?
I guess if the kids aren't writing, but only in exams do they have to write, they write the correct answer.But the writing is so ugly the teacher can't read it, it kind of seems unfair for them to fail the exam when they could type the answers correctly and clearly it's easy for everyone. All right, well there you go, an interesting end to an interesting article, and we'll have more coming up very, very soon. Until then, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
课文提到，有些学校啊，甚至把笔试废除，让学生改用笔记型电脑来完成考试。哎，就是因为学生的字写得不好看，让老师很难阅读，很难阅卷评分。那除此之外，学生们常常会用笔记型电脑来做笔记，而不是用手写，因此丧失了书写能力。我们先来看单字 read。Rid 这个动词表示使什么除去或是摆脱，它的三态同形 rid, rid, rid。那么文中的片语 get rid of 表示除去或是废除掉什么，其中这个 rid 是它过去分词。刚刚老师没有提到片语 do away with。Do away with 也可以用来表达废止啊、除去或是摆脱。那还有用到一个动词叫 eliminate。Eliminate 它是拼作 E-L-I-M-I-N-A-T-E， 那这个字它表示排除啊、消除、消灭等等。最后帮同学们补充一个形容词叫做 legible。Legible 它拼作 L-E-G-I-B-L-E， 那这个字它可以用来描述字迹或是文件等等是清楚的、是容易阅读的、容易辨认的。那它的相反词是在字首再加上 I-L， 变成 illegible。Illegible 就表示难以阅读的、难以辨认的。好啦，以上是这些讲解，同学别走开，马上回来哦。大家好，我是 Hanny。在今天的课程中，我们要介绍三个文法重点。第一个是 aside from 的不同意思，第二个是 So 加上形容词或副词，加上 that 子句。第三个是 which 代指前方子句的用法。首先，我们来学习 aside from 的不同意思。偏语介系词 aside from 后面可以接名词或动名词，跟 apart from 的用法相同，都可以用来指下列两种意思。第一种是表达除了什么什么之外就没有什么了，那么意思跟 except for 相同。例如 aside from the sound of the ceiling fan, the room was quiet. 除了天花板吊扇的声音之外，整间房间都很安静。第二种是表达除了什么什么之外还有什么，那么意思跟 besides 相同。例如 aside from singing, she's also good at dancing. 除了唱歌之外，她也很擅长跳舞。接下来我们来学习 so 加上形容词或副词，加上 that 子句。句型 so 加上形容词或副词，加上 that 子句，表示如此怎么样，以至于怎么样，或是非常怎么样，结果怎么样。 so 后面接形容词或副词，用来强调某事物的程度高到造成某种结果，而后方的 that 子句就是用来说明结果。来看两个例句。The book was so interesting that she couldn't stop reading it. 那本书如此的有趣，以至于她读到欲罢不能。Tom wrote so slowly that he couldn't finish the report in time. Tom 写得太慢，以至于没有办法及时完成报告。最后，我们来学习 which 代指前方子句的用法。关系代名词 which 可以代指前方整个子句。那 which 所引导的关系子句是用来补充说明前面的句子，那这是非限定用法， which 的前面必须加逗号。例如 Nick is the first person in his family to graduate from college, which makes his parents proud. Nick 是他们家族第一个大学毕业的人，这让他爸妈很骄傲。那句中的 which 是用来指前面所提到的整件事，也就是指 Nick 是他们家族第一个大学毕业的人。那 which makes his parents proud 表示这件事让他爸妈很骄傲。那其中的 which 可以省略不用，再将 makes 改成现在分词 making， 那么这个句子可以简化成 Nick is the first person in his family to graduate from college.Making his parents proud. 以上是今天重点整理，我们下次见喽。See you next time. Bye.
劝别人不要沉迷网络或手机游戏，你该怎么说呢？
欢迎收看就爱讲英文，
他是 Jay 吉安，我是
悠悠。
对，每天大家都沉迷在手机里面，我们一定要告诉大家这很危险。
对，
什么视力减退啦，身心疲劳啦，然后也不会跟人家相处，这很糟糕。
真的，我们今天就教大家三个关于这个手机成瘾的后遗症。I feel uncomfortable without my phone. I'm just addicted to the internet.That's because you have a great fear of missing out.
大家现在都会这样子，什么都可以忘记带，但手机不能忘记带。
真的，钱包没有带没关系。
对，然后
手机不能忘了带。
什么人都可以不重要，但是手机很重要。
对，所以少了手机就会不对劲。完蛋。OK，
真的。
我们要怎么讲这句话？你可以说 I feel uncomfortable without something.
I feel uncomfortable without 哒哒哒。
对，我少了什么就浑身不舒服，
不舒服，
不自在，这样
不爽快。
Okay. 那记得哦 ，comfortable 这个字呢是心里的舒服、嗯。你如果说身体不舒服的话，不是什么 uncomfortable，、
嗯、
不是，是什么 unwell。
unwell。
哦 ，unwell、嗯。所以这边这个 uncomfortable 是心里的不舒服。
心里不舒服。
I feel uncomfortable without my phone.
I feel uncomfortable without my phone.
没有了手机，我浑身不对劲啊！
对
对 对,
对，
所以呢，有这样的一个状况，就会有新的一个名词出来。
什么新东西？
叫做 nomophobia。
这什么东西啊、嗯、
？Nomophobia， 我们知道 phobia 这个字呢，就是
什么什么症
吧？恐惧症。
OK，
对对，就是害怕什么什么东西。嗯、他害怕什么呢 ？Normal， normal 就是 no mobile, no mobile 的这个简称。
所以就是说他没有手机就会恐惧的意思，
无手机恐惧症
哦
，nomophobia， 对对对，
哇，那这样大家都有这个病嘞 ，nomophobia，nomophobia，
手机没电就恐慌了这样。
对，而且那种网络成瘾、手机成瘾啊、嗯，现在小朋友这小小就这样成瘾了，
太可怕了，
真的。
沉迷抑郁这件事情呢，我们就用be addicted to，
be addicted to，
所以 someone is addicted to something。
Someone is addicted to something.
对, 对，某个人呢，他已经成瘾了，就是某个东西他上瘾了。所以，比如说他一天到晚在用手机，我就可以跟他说 ，You are so addicted to your phone.
I'm so addicted to my phone.
对,
对，
那沉迷手机干嘛呢？因为沉迷在网络的世界。哇 ，I'm just addicted. I'm just so addicted to the internet.
I'm just.Addicted to the internet.
对，我非常沉迷网络的世界。
但是你知道，这个手机成瘾、网络成瘾的话，一定会有后遗症，会让人觉得很空虚，然后不想出门，不想跟人家社交，什么都会跟不上。
怕跟不上，
对不？哦，怕跟不上，
怕跟不上。这个呢，其实前一阵子有出来的一个字哈，叫做什么 ？FOMO。
FOMO
又来了，
又是什么东西？
这是什么？Fear of missing out。
Fear of missing out.
OK, miss out 的话就是错过了，
对，
错失了一些机会或者是一些场合。那 fear 是恐惧、哦、所以呢 ，fear of missing out 就是害怕跟不上，害怕人家都出去玩，害怕人家都到美丽的景点打卡，然后我跟不上，所以呢，这个就变成了 FOMO。
FOMO、哦。
那有这样的一个恐惧呢，就是 have a fear of something。
Have a fear of something.
所以 I have a fear of missing out. Have FOMO 这样。
哦，那我觉得网络成瘾就是你害怕这个失落的原因，是不是？ Mm-hmm.
对对 ，That's because you have a great fear of missing out.
That's because you have a great fear of missing out. 所以才会一直沉迷在网络世界里面，真的很糟糕。大家真的要特别注意哦。来看今天的
live action.
Okay. I feel so tired.
That's probably because you have been using your phone for hours.
But I feel uncomfortable without my phone.
That's called nomophobia.
What?
No mobile phone phobia. No mobile phobia.
Okay, I'm just so addicted to this phone and the internet.
And that's because you have a great fear of missing out.
You're right. You're right.